Now, the Forum on Disarmament and Development has warned a large number of small arms are moving within the country undetected. The Forum has stressed on the need for Sri Lanka to accede to the arms trade treaty.
Small arms are circulating in the country, but they are not detected. Yet it takes place in large scale. In 2005, former President Chandrika Kumaratunga appointed a national commission to deal with the proliferation of illicit small arms and light weapons. Weapons were collected in 2006. We see the paramount importance of such a commission. We are not aware of the post-war weapons circulating in Sri Lanka. In 1988, local government members were given weapons like the AK-47, but those were never recovered. The innocent people will have to face the consequences of this. These incidents take us back to the avant-garde floating armory, where a large quantity of weapons were stored in a dangerous manner. Yet, the manner in which these weapons were obtained and who used them remains a mystery. On the 15th of November 2017, News First filed the following report on the matter. What is the exact number of weapons that were taken over by security forces from the vessel that was owned by avant-garde? Reports surfaced the serial numbers of some weapons seized by the security forces had been erased and some weapons did not have a serial number at all. The present government of good governance claimed the operations and the floating armory of avant-garde were illegal and promised to carry out an extensive investigation along with bringing those accountable before the law.